In this video, we'll use a free program called Texture Packer to help us create a sprite sheet that we'll use for animation in P5.js using the P5 Play library. One of the big reasons that we would want to use a sprite sheet is to combine many individual animation files into one. That's something that can help your real-time rendered applications, your games, your interactive sketches run a lot faster. In my browser here, I've gone ahead to the Texture Packer website and clicked on the download link, and that's going to get me the installer for Texture Packer. I'm on a Mac. This also exists for Windows and Linux, and it is virtually identical. Now, I've already gone ahead and downloaded Texture Packer, and I've also exported a bunch of PNG frames that I'll plan to use for an animation. Now, I happen to export these from After Effects, but there's lots of different ways to make the individual frames that you would later then put into a sprite sheet. So let's go ahead and double-click on Texture Packer to open it up. And here we get the option to try the pro version or use the free version. We're going to stick with the free version. The pro does have some nice features, but this should give us pretty much everything we need. Our Texture Packer interface is divided up into three main columns. On the left, we'll be importing sprites, which are essentially the frames that we'll be combining together into one big sheet. In the middle, we'll see a visual of what that sprite sheet will look like. And on the right, we've got some dropdowns and text boxes for adjusting the settings we'd like to apply to our sprite sheet. So I want to take all of these PNG images, and I'm just going to select all of them, click and drag into my sprites column. I've got all these images here. I think it's about 178, 180 images. So I can see here in the middle what this is going to look like, where Texture Packer has basically laid out in a grid all of the individual image files that I'm importing from the sprites column. And down at the bottom, I can click the zoom slider to see everything all at once or more detail on an individual sprite. So I'm noticing here the canvas for my sprite sheet is actually pretty small in comparison with the number of sprite frames that I have. So there's lots of these sprites that are cascading off the sheet. So my first step here, I'm going to adjust the scale of my sprites so that everything fits on one sheet. So let's double click on any of the sprites. And what I want to do is highlight everything in the sprites column. So I'm going to hit Command A. And over in the right-hand column, I can see that sprite-specific scaling setting, along with the preview of each of my individual sprites in the middle. So here, let's just bump this down. I think something about 0.25 is going to be pretty good to get everything onto that one sprite sheet. Once I've set that, I'm going to click this Back to Sheet button, and that looks much better. So let's adjust our zoom again. That's great. Now we're ready to move on to some of these settings over here in the right-hand column. Our output files will determine if we need any additional data that would go along with the sprite sheet image itself. I don't need that in this case, so I'm just going to ignore that first output files section. Let's go down to image format, and here we can set the pixel image format for the sprite sheet itself. So PNG 32, I think, is going to work pretty well for us. We might be able to get away with PNG 8. That would give us a smaller file size, but a little bit less nuance as we move from opaque to transparent textures. So let's leave it on PNG 32 for now. I've also got some options for the pixel format. So this has to do with what type and how much information we're embedding in each of our pixels. So right now we're in this RGBA 8888 format. That's a 32-bit per pixel with alpha transparency pixel-based image. So that's one of the highest information formats we could encode into a PNG. Maybe if we wanted to save memory later on, we could switch to a different format. Again, for now, I'm just going to leave this on the default. Our packing section helps us to determine how each of the individual sprites are laid out on the sprite sheet itself. The most important one you want to pay attention to here is the max size. So here we've got four different settings, each in increments that are powers of two. So 512, 1024, 2048. When we're packing sprites for a mobile screen, 2048 is the biggest dimension that we want to hit. So I want to make sure I leave that on 2048. All the rest of these settings I could pretty much leave alone, and I'm ready at this point to save out my Texture Packer project. So that's going to save my links to all the sprites, the scaling settings, the layout on the sprite sheet, and any settings that I've made in the right-hand column here. So let's go up to the Save Project icon, and I'm just going to save right into this folder where my frames are, and I'll call this Laptop Sprite Project. Just go ahead and click Save, and now I can see I've saved that out as a .tps file. So that way I can easily bring this project back up if I wanted to make changes, maybe choose a different pixel format or file format, for example. So once I've done that, I can publish my sprite sheet. So this is going to save out the actual PNG that I would use in my coding. And again, just going right into that folder, and I'll call this laptop sprite sheet.png, and go ahead and click save. Now I get a little bit of output in terms of how the job went. So all green check marks here, that's looking good. Sometimes you'll come across errors. Either there's something misformatted in your file, or if you're using the free version and you try to access a feature that's only available in Pro, you'll get some red warning messages. But this looks great. Let's go ahead and click OK. If I go back up to my file, I can see I've got that sprite sheet image. So I can take that right into my P5 sketch, set that up as an animation really easily. Okay, so that's a nice quick overview of making a sprite sheet in Texture Packer.